something you could be able to do today? Do you have the money to do it today?
Say it like this. Don't say, would you have the money today? Would that be comfortable for your budget?
Would you be comfortable with that today in your budget?
Well, no, not really. That's, we just had a new baby. We just bought a new TV. Christmas is coming real fast. So I'm kind of watching my money, right? I mean, I love it. And if money wasn't an issue right now, I'd give you a card in a second. But I'm, you know, with the new baby and everything, we're watching our money right now.
Certainly, I understand. And I appreciate the fact that you're on top of your finances, and maybe this is not for you. I tell you what, though, on certain conditions, he has been willing to, you know, make some exceptions and help you out with that. What would you feel comfortable, you know, today if you were able to make something work for you? Okay. What kind of money are you working with today?
Okay, time out, off the role play. What you can use is a guts move now. Okay. You did that well, but we can make that even better. You can say something like, you know, I speak with Claude on a regular basis. Truth. Always tell the truth, by the way. You don't have to lie about anything. I speak with Claude on a fairly regular basis. I could ask him a personal favor if he'd finance this for you at zero interest. You put something down today, maybe half down or whatever's comfortable for you. And then we split it up into 2-3 payments, or that wouldn't make a difference, would it?
Right, right. That's so much better. And it's so much more real and controlled. You know, I'm gonna ask you a question, Claude.
Okay.
When I'm talking to clients, I feel like I'm rushing. I feel like I gotta talk really, really fast because I feel like they're gonna interrupt me and kick me out. And I think I need to slow down, be in control, like, you know, kind of way you're talking, you know, just
if you were my next door neighbor and you wanted to invite me over on Thanksgiving for some pumpkin pie and some strawberry rhubarb pie, how would you say, hey, Claude, you got to come over here real fast. Grandma just pulled the pies out of the oven there. Hey, Claude, how's your Thanksgiving and everything? Hey, this is Mike down the street and everything. You know what? My grandmother's here and she made too many pies. Do you like pie, Mike?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Oh, well, I've got a pumpkin pie, fresh made. I've got a strawberry rhubarb pie. I've got a Boston cream. How about you and your wife come on over here? Have a quick, have some pie, or I can put a plate to go for you if you want.
Right. You're probably like a lot of salespeople. You have trouble with, talking to clients, making those cold calls. Everybody's sick of getting rejected and doing all this work for free. Does that ring a bell? Are you having any of those issues, Claude?
Yeah. Off the role play. That was a great question. Tell them that you have that problem too.
I have that problem.
You know, I don't know about you, but I had a problem in sales. I didn't like the rejection and bothering people and stuff like that. But you know, we're both in sales. How do you learn how to build your confidence and get people to trust you? Are you utilizing a system right now to overcome those kind of challenges that I had? You don't have those problems, do you?
And then if they did, how am I going to transition? Okay, now I'm the expert, but I've just asked him to help me.
I found a solution. You know what? I found this guy online. Tell the truth. The truth is wonderful. Do you know why? You know, you don't have to be I say you have to be a psychologist and a thespian. The thespian part is easy if you're telling the truth. You're just reliving the things that really happened.
You know, that something rings true to me because I'm trying to be the expert like you teach, but it's actually better if I'm just open and honest and truthful that, well, I'm working at being the expert. I may not be the expert right now, but I found the